this place. But God is able to change your situation. He's able.
Well, you know what? I do need to do this. Let me do this real quick. Just real quick.
All right. Okay. Are you happy that the storm?
Yes, I'm happy that the storm.
All right. What's up, everybody? It's once again. It is Talent Tuesday. We are Quantize Recordings, and we are here to check out hopefully some good music. Hope you enjoy it. Hope we enjoy it. I hope I enjoy it.
I think you will.
You listened to it already?
I listened to a few things just because I wanted to make sure that everything was going to sound okay.
Okay.
So yeah,
I did
some listening.
Well, who are you?
I am DJ Spen.
You are DJ Spen. Well, yes. Welcome DJ Spen to the show. Welcome over on Facebook. We've got our friend Ronan checking in from... I don't appreciate those angry faces over on Facebook. I'm going to block you as soon as I figure out who you are.
Why do we have angry faces?
But my friend
faces?
Ronan is checking in from Brazil. Hello. And hello to all the Twitch fam. Soulful Susie, Mike Freak, Lamore Disco... all in the house. Good to see you all.
Yeah.
And we've got Mixcloud running as well. I don't know who's on Mixcloud. I see a couple people watching on Mixcloud. They don't talk in the chat much, but that's all right. What's up, Mixcloud? And I think YouTube is with us as well. So we should get right into this. We have one of our very favorite producers and very favorite people.
Yeah.
Would you like to do the honors of introducing this gentleman?
First of all, he is celebrating a birthday. That's first of all.
Would you like to sing?
You know what? I do. You know what? Check it out. I do. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Oh my goodness.
Happy birthday, John Morales. Happy birthday to you.
Okay.
I think I'm going to have to press that on vinyl.
I was about to say, I don't know what John might do with that vocal, but...
No, he'll never press it on vinyl.
I'll send that vocal to my friend DJ so you can kind of fix it and tune it up.
Oh, man. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we have with us a very special guest by the name of John Morales. He is one of the most, probably, I'm going to go out on a limb and say here, the most famous remixer of disco tracks that's still doing what it is that we're doing. Yeah. So he's done records like Somebody Else's Guy. He's done records like Over Like a Fat Rat.
My jam right there.
I mean, like all of the records that I like grew up to, that I consider to be the bedrock of what we do as soulful dance music, this guy has done. I mean, he's done craziness like take cassettes and turn them from a cassette into something that's playable, actual playable vinyl from a cassette. This is what this guy has done. So I can't say too much other than he's a master at production and a master at mixing and a master at pulling things together that don't even belong together, and he's a dope DJ. Ladies and gentlemen, his name is John Morales.
Hey, John.
Thank you. Hi, guys. Thank you for the accolade.
Yeah, man.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us. So this is your second Talent Tuesday with us, isn't it?
Yeah, this is the second one. The first one wasn't too eventful, if I remember well. But
no, it wasn't. Okay. Well,
I think I wasn't feeling great or something. Oh, so.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully you have some good feedback. We have, what, five songs?
Yeah, we got five songs tonight.
All right, we have five songs tonight.
Yeah, we're going to see where they go, and hopefully we'll have some decent feedback.
I just want everybody to buy my records so I can get some food.
Oh, right. So you can get some food.
Tell us about your records, John.
Yeah, you may as well. Tell us what you've got going on here.
Where do we start? Currently we have our Jocelyn Brown Caught Up in a One Night Love Affair.
Ooh. Yeah.
I think it's like 45 years after we originally did it. We redone it kind of more up-tempo. Currently sitting at number 2 on the track source chart, so...
Who's number one? Who we got to kick out of the way?
Michael Gray and Fly Away. Well, I just want him to fly his ass away. So we need all our Quantized friends to go over to TrackSource and pick it up. Yes. And then, of course, we have our All Queued Up Volume 3, 10 Years of Quantized. Really 13. It took 3 years to finally get it out. But,
yeah.
So I've been part of the Quantized family almost since, you know, when it turned from Code Red to Quantized and Unquantized, and just happy to call Mr. Spen and Mrs. Spen family. So, and Tommy, of course.
Oh, who? This guy right here?
Yeah.
Oh, there he goes. There he goes.
Is he there?
Yeah, he's there. What is Lola that Falana in the back? Lola Falana, what you got? Wings in the back, just chilling.
Well,
it's like a bat cave.
I gotta fly out after the show. So
get to fly out and do a show.
Yeah. Okay.
Fair enough. And last but not least, we may as well, since we're doing introductions, there's this cat right here named Freaky Mike. Mike Freak. Yes.
He's managing director of our newest label, our baby label, Q or Q3, whatever you want to call
whichever way you want to call
Q-U-3.
It.
Q-U-3.
Q-U-3.
Hey, Mike Freak. It's supposed to be called Q, but people couldn't get past that 3. The 3 is like a play on the E, you know? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's the third.
Yes, it's the third Quantized label, so that's why it's called Q, Quantized, Unquantized.
All right, so we got Quantized, we got Unquantized. And Q.
Yes.
And Q.
Yes.
All right, so speaking of Q, what do we have? We have 5 songs tonight.
We do. Shout out to Vonita White. She is instructing you not to sing like that again. She knows you can do much better.
Tell Vonita White, the
legendary songstress from Jasper Street Company.
She never likes me singing.
Is over there on Facebook.
You also have someone drop us a gift subs on Twitch.
Oh, really? Thank you. Over on Twitch, we had some gift subs going on. Oh, who did it?
DJ Dom.
Nice. Thank you for all the gifts over there on Twitch, our Soulful Susie, our moderator, hey, is in the chat. Susie,
what's up, Sidecart? We Black see you. Greco Soul Official.
Angelica is there.
Hey, Angelica. Angelica.
Yeah, this chat is flying by too quick for me. So
yeah,
I just
it does fly by. When you see it pauses, because I paused it because I can't follow.
Yeah, I just want to send my love to everybody in the chat and thank them for joining us today, and just thank them for supporting all the efforts of Quantized. It's not an easy task to put this music together and put it out to you guys. So I definitely appreciate all the love.
And we appreciate you, John.
Yes, we do. Man.
All right.
John Morales is ready. Let's go. Yeah, let's have John Morales as a regular host there. He's ready.
Really, as a regular host, John? You hear that, right?
If we can tear him away from his production.
Yeah, if you can, right, from doing Marvin Gaye and Jocelyn Brown and that kind of a thing. Right. I mean, we would be low on the totem pole, I would imagine.
I could play some Marvin.
What, are you working on Marvin Gaye now? Play it again. Wait a minute. Hold on. So you working on a remix of Come Get to This by Marvin Gaye, and it sounds like it's live. Is that true?
It is. It's Marvin Gaye Live, 1974 at the Oakland Coliseum.
We not messing with you. We can't mess with you. That's why nobody can mess with you.
Hey,
come get to this right now.
As you all know, I'm just sitting here in my cave, all locked up, just doing what I do. You know.
Yes, sir. Well, you continue to do what you do, and I can't wait to hear that.
So, producers, I hope you're ready for some true professional feedback. You're going to get it from the one and only John Morales tonight. All right, we are going to move right on into this. What's the name of our first song?
First song is called Boogie Pants.
Boogie Pants. I saw this and I really did laugh a lot when I saw the title. Boogie Pants, right here on Talent Tuesday. You heard it here first. Drop us a note in the chat. Watch for the poll on Twitch and let us know how you feel about this first one. It's Talent Tuesday.
Put your boogie pants on, and those booger shoes. Then we're gonna grab a cab, go downtown and find a place to boogie. You know, that kind of place that only has people in the door. You knock on it and then you need to say the password. And the password for tonight is Sweaty Boogie Pattern. It's a groovy place, it's your boom. Where we can get our moves on, it's your boom. And if the DJ ain't playing it right, we just walk up there and let him know, it's your boom. Cause it's your boom. We are here to get down and boogie. It's your boom. We don't mind the other round, it's your boom. We just wanna do our thing until the doorman throws us out. Get your boogie pants on, cause tonight I wanna get down. Get your boogie pants on, cause tonight I wanna get down. Get your boogie pants on, cause tonight I wanna get down. Get your boogie pants on, cause tonight I wanna get down.
Your boogie pants.
Put your booty pants.
You know, do
on,
a little boogie.
Cause tonight, Sean wants to get down.
Okay. Let's see how everyone feels about this one. We should go right to Mr. Morales.
All right.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
It definitely works for me. I could definitely do something with this. I kind of like the whole novelty of it, you know, but the track is kicking. I like the little horn riffs, mm-hmm. and stuff. I mean, I probably throw a sax solo in there somewhere. I kind of thought the middle part, the talking part, was a little bit too long about what he's going to do in the club and get in and talk to the DJ. And, you know, so I would kind of thin some of that out, but I could work with that. So I think the production is pretty decent, and I give it a 7.5.
All right, a 7.5 from John Morales.
That is tremendous.
Yeah, I actually like the vibe. I like the vibe it has, you know. So
okay,
kind of got that summer feel.
Is this something that you would play like at Glitterbox Ibiza? Like, would you?
I would.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would play it.
At Glitterbox or specifically or?
Yeah, they're kind of a disco-y event.
Yeah.
You know, it reminds me of another track I'm trying to, I'll think of it, but it had the kind of same kind of low talking vibe. You know, I mean, if you strip the vocal out, the track I think is really nice. You know,
so do I.
You know, the bass, I mean, you can't hear it like on the computer, but the bass seems like it's playing a really nice progression. You know, the horn licks are pretty good. So I think on the production side, it is pretty good. So I think there's a lot you can do with it. So, you know, send it over.
There
you go.
All right.
Uh-huh.
Interesting, a 7.5.
Yeah.
Okay, Tommy Davis, talk to us.
Well, first of all, Kelly, you look fabulous. I love it.
Thank you, darling. Thank you, darling.
I kind of agree with John. I'm not a novelty kind of person because it's either hit or miss. If it's a hit, it go number one. If it's a miss, it sit down in the bottom. And you never know. I mean, ever since my favorite record, Disco Duck, just fizzled out.
Did you literally say your favorite record? Like Disco Duck? Wait a minute. Wait.
He's joking.
Disco Duck was one of your favorite records. Don't try it.
No. And Disco Tex and the Sex of Lads? Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Fair enough.
But the production was on par. It was tight. And the producer, you know what you're doing. Because you nailed it and the way it moved and, you know, and the vocal set right on top of the track. Clearly, you can understand right. what it was, what he was saying. Right. You know what I mean? So it had a vibe of its own. So I give it a 7 just because it was put together really right. This is what we want with demos. We want them to sound as tight as you can make them. That means the less we have to do to bring it up to what our fans and audience like.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mike Freak, talk to us.
Yeah, I agree with what everyone said. If there's anything like I think that needed fixing was the vocals. Like it felt like the vocals wasn't sitting right in the mix, and while it did sound clear, I think it could be fixed and made it sound even clearer because it's a little muddy on some parts on the vocals. So
yeah.
Other than that, I think it's a good track. I think this one is really good.
Okay, and how about Twitch? What did the Twitch?
96% said yes.
All really, 96% yes.
I'm telling you, it's got that sauce.
Yeah.
A bit of a mixed response over on Facebook. Phil Rose, hey Phil Rose, giving it a 3. Phil is not really into this one. But,
Phil,
let me
text his ass.
text him because he said a 3. Ronan Ramos. Says is that a 9.5? And Nicola Caravelli says a 7. So a mixed response over on Facebook. Like what do you think?
All right. I just sorted him out.
You sorted him out, John?
Right. Yep. Like, what are you saying?
Okay, Phil Rose, check your text message.
Put your booty pants on.
It's boogie pants. It's not boogie.
It should be called booty pants.
Boogie
is passe. Booty is
I mean, before we get on to the other ones, like Tommy said, it's not just the whole, boogie pants thing. It's like the track is really well put together. So it really kind of shifts the focus from it, because the progression and the arrangement that the guy has is pretty good. I mean, I would do my thing to it, but I could see it, a couple of different mixes making some noise, especially for the summertime.
Yeah,
so.
I agree. I think what really does it, in all seriousness, what does it is the instrumental.
Oh yeah, the horn riff. I mean, it's just well put together. For the first track for tonight, we're doing all right.
Okay.
Yeah. So, it's very well done.
So Kelly, what do you got to say?
Yeah. I'm not really a fan of the vocals, but when I heard that little disco, that got me moving right away. I wasn't, but I'm not too big on the vocals, but I love the sound, without the vocals.
Yeah. I can tell y'all right now, we signed this right.
Here's my Phil Rose roast me back. He said, that's a terrible track. You got enough boogie pants to wear. Never mind, click.
Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Rose is a very influential DJ, let's say, from the UK. And he knows his stuff.
He goes by the name of Jager Rosa.
Yes, he does. And he's a good DJ, so trust me.
Phil, by the time I finish mixing this, you're going to play.
Correct.
All right. The challenge has been thrown down, and we will see.
Yeah, because we're signing this record. I want y'all to know. Yeah, I love it.
We can all do something with it, you know. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I think I give it like a 8.
Yeah.
Really?
Because the instrumentation is fabulous.
Huh.
Huh. Yeah. The instrumentation is absolutely fabulous.
If you get beyond the vocal and listen to what's going on musically,
yeah.
You know, you can see that there's something there, you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do like the music. Play it. Let me see
it again. It's got a bounce to it, you know?
It does.
Yeah.
And the horn work is absolutely killer.
Yeah, I'm telling you, let's go. All right,
the horns are Louis Vega level killer.
Shut the show down. Let's get to work.
All right. Well, looks like we got one.
All right, let's go. Yeah,
let's go on to number two. Let's all right, see. Yep, this one is two. Called Don't Know. No, actually, wait a minute.
Yeah, it is.
I think it's actually called You Don't Know Me.
Oh.
Okay. We just cut the title off. It's called You Don't Know Me.
Okay.
So let's check this one out and see how it goes.
It's Talent Tuesday. We'll be right back.
vocals that I like. There's something about the track that sounds a little
interesting.
Elementary, I think is the word that I want.
Okay, all right.
Okay, let me hear what our judges have to say.
Esteemed judges, all right, go ahead, John. What do you think?
I kind of would agree with Kelly. It's I like it, but it leaves you feeling like it's missing something. Mm-hmm. I like the vocals, but it almost sounds like it's missing like something over the top. You know, somebody ad-libbing or kind of taking the song somewhere else. I mean, the kalimbas that are kind of doing that little melody thing, I don't know if I like it or don't like it. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know. I like it, but it needs some work. It's not there yet.
Okay.
So I would probably give it like a 6.
All right.
Okay.
It has potential. You know, I kept waiting for something else to happen for a vocal to kind of be on top of that like hook that it has. You know, that you don't mean a thing, blah, 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 you know. Because that almost sounds like a background, like a unison background part. So that's kind of what I was hearing.
All right. Fair enough. Okay. So he already gave it a number. Mike, what do you think?
Yeah, I think there's a whole lot of ideas going on in here and, you know, trying to put it all together. It felt like the vocals was not matching the key of the music, so I guess that's the disconnect right there for me. So I actually like the music better than the vocals. But that's just me. I think the music is good. It needs something else though to kind of like bring it a little over that, you know, make it sound more cohesive.
Yeah, pretty much what John was saying. Exact same thing.
Yeah.
Exact same thing.
If the vocals, I think it could come up with a different song with the vocals. That's just how I feel about it.
Right. And leave the track as is?
Yeah, or put a different vocal. It feels like it's a sample.
I kind of agree. It does sound like it came out of a sample pack or something. Yeah. Because the vocals never really did anything except mm-hmm. what it was doing.
Right. Mm-hmm. So that's what it felt like for me. So
okay.
It's production is pretty good. It just needs a little polishing here and there. Just making sure like the ideas are, you know, solid. You know, you have your intro, you have your outro, and then you're adding elements here and there. It should sound cohesive. So that's what I didn't get right there. So this one, I'll give this one a 6. I like the music. Vocals, maybe find a different sample or, you know, or tune the vocals to the music if you can. You know, you have tools to do that.
Okay.
Okay.
And also on Twitch, it was 82%
no. 82%
no
on Twitch.
Yeah. Okay.
We're savage on Twitch.
Interesting. Phil Rose giving it a 5 on Facebook. Nicola Caravelli giving it a 6. Okay, so Phil gave this one a little bit more. He likes the back end of this. It has some nice elements, just not a killer hook. Right. So that hook is so important. We talk about that. You know, we want people singing that hook again and again in their head.
Right.
That's what makes them play and buy your records.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right, Tommy Davis, what do you think? Are you in agreement or...
Well, I agree definitely. Spen, what's that? What's that like 120 or 180?
Yeah, it's 120.
All right, so, you know, with this new and piano movement, we're watching the music do a slow, come down in an energy. And so I think they kind of captured that kind of turn, you know what I mean? Personally, I don't get it. You have to be John Morales to make me dance to something that's 118 or something. John could do it well. But it just seemed like it didn't go anywhere. It stayed. It had all the parts there. But I have to sit in these board meetings with Spen, Kelly, and Mike. And they'll say, you know what? next year, y'all not signing nothing that you aren't flipping your head. If you're not doing a handstand for it, that's don't sign it.
You're not jumping up and down. Yep. You can't give it a 9 or a 10. That's what we said.
Unfortunately, that's where it's going.
That's always in the back of my head.
Oh, my gosh. Right, Tommy.
Right. No, because you know what happens. We are listening to these songs, and when you, this is just like in my other life, like when I'm interviewing people, you know, I interview a really bad person. Almost anything that comes next after that, it's like, yes, you are amazing. Until I meet with them again and sit down by myself and meet with them. And I'm like, what was I thinking? You all do the same thing.
Well, maybe they had a good day.
And what I say is, hey, are you, you know, we're putting this song out. Remember this song we signed from Talent Tuesday? And then you all are yelling at me. Who picked Kelly? Who signed this song? This song, I got to spend all day working with the
y'all
parts.
Y'all just telling the whole
story. That's what happens,
story.
Right? So we get excited, but we really have to ask the question, the hard question. It's not just, you know, hey, how does it sound? Is it ready right now? Is it ready?
Right.
And that's what we're asking about every song. When I ask you to give it a number, not on its potential, is it ready? Because John might, out of the kindness of his heart, say, you know what? I really want to work with that song. I like it. But guess what? John Morales ain't free. I don't care if he offered. Not. He's not free. He's not free. And I'm not paying for it. You're going to pay for it, artist. So, yeah. You know, that's the other
Which
thing.
Which is interesting. You know, we just had a situation.
Yo, hold on one second. I got to get the door because Gail's out.
Oh, go do your thing. Do your thing. We got
We're
you.
We're here.
I'm
going to eat my Skittles.
So we just had a little bit of a situation where we had an artist who was a little bit upset because we sent out the statements and there was a charge that...
This happens all the time, though.
Yeah. But I mean, but there was a charge for promotion, right? And it was a hefty charge because the promotion that we decided to use on that record was, I mean, it cost. And everybody was in agreement with it, believe it or not. But it almost like the artist was like, well, who is this person that you decided to use as a promoter? We don't use any slouches. No. But at the end of the day, it upset the person because they saw this negative amount on their statement. And it's like, listen, we try things with a lot of different records and a lot of different artists. Most of what we do does well, but the biggest records that we do are the most known records. It's kind of the same thing that, you know, I always go back to Motown. You know, Motown did hundreds of records between 1964 and like 1966, hundreds of records, mm-hmm. but we probably only know about 20 of them.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, this is sort of taking a chance. Because, you know, if we believe in something, we put everything that we have behind it, but not everything goes
and
the way that we
want it to go. And we can't
guarantee
that. Yeah. I mean, we don't know. I mean, John Morales could touch it and it still doesn't do anything. You know, you could have Tommy Davis, DJ Spen, Mike Free, you could have all kinds of remix package and it still doesn't do anything. And then on the flip side, we've had songs that we've said, okay, you all signed this. This is, and we have been shocked at how well the songs, you know, do. We have people calling us like, hey, we really love, you know, DJs will call, radio, you know, people will call and say, we are so interested in this song that we really didn't think would do well. So there's no special sauce. We don't know, you know, how the rest of the world will feel about a song.
And that's where I was going. When I'm listening to these songs, I'm listening to A, the first I want to critique the producers. Like, dude, that was a great job. And he mm-hmm. did a great job of doing, of telling his story. A song is a story. It's a poem. Even in musically. He did a really great job. Can I say that this record's going to do really well
mm-hmm.
with our team? So I don't want to set someone up when I'm getting a feeling that the market we have, is iffy. You know what I mean? So we rather go and throw all of it into something that we really believe in and eat crow if we're wrong. But if we start to feel this, then we're like, you know what? I think you'd be better looking for someone else that could actually get behind it and fit their audience. So I don't want the producers out there to think we're criticizing things, saying your things are trash. No, we're not. Right, we're saying it's just not for us because we have what we need.
Is it ready? Yeah, we're asking, is it ready right now? Is it right for one of our labels? You know, each label has its own personality. I mean, look at who's on the screen, right? These are the three label heads, right? There's a personality with each label. And so is it wild and funky? Is it new and fresh? Is it your classic soulful? What is it?
Yeah.
And, you know, does it fit, you know, into one of those
About this track, the track is a good track. It's a good track. And just my opinion, it could sit probably in the middle of the chart, but we don't aim for middle. We aim for the top. And the middle is third place. It's like, so I don't want to put an artist on there and have to deal with Kelly saying, next year, y'all better sign better records than this.
It looks like John Morales is talking to an electrician, so we'll get him
on. Shout out to DJ Sir Roddick. I've never met you. Hello over there on Mixcloud. I'm not sure if that was this song or the one before you were given a 7, but I see you got Mixcloud open now. All right, well, we should roll on. Hey, yes. James Stark, good to
What's
see
up,
you.
What's up, James?
Miss Tucker in the house on Facebook.
What's up?
Hey, Barbara Tucker is in the house on Facebook.
Barbara Tucker and Vonita over on Facebook.
Yes.
Ooh, heavy hitter.
Yes. Stephen Martin. You know who Stephen Martin is?
Yes, I know who Stephen Martin is.
He said the general is in the house. That's one of my nicknames. Yes, the general don't play. Nope, sure don't.
What's up, Steve? All right.
All right, let's roll on. What's this next one?
This song is called So Good, and we're going to see how good So Good actually is.
Yeah, and this is the last time this particular producer will be on Talent Tuesday because they are generally so good and have had a record signed before. So let's go. Let's hear let's how good this one is.
All right, it's Talent Tuesday, y'all.
Follow your lead.
John Morales back yet? Nope. And okay. Mike Freak has gone off to be okay, well, Stream let's... Master. So it's us and
all right. Well, let's see. 100% so far on Facebook saying this is so good. Uh-huh. I am definitely a fan of this producer, and this producer knows that, which is interesting that they didn't send the song to me particularly, which he does sometimes. So, I mean, we can hear what everybody else has to say. It doesn't matter. I already emailed the producer and said, I want the song. So, we can listen. DJ Spen.
He didn't even tell me.
I already told him.
Okay.
I exercised my power.
Okay, that's fine. Mm-hmm. Tens. Okay, so you gave it a 10?
I thought it was so good.
All right, good.
Okay, I mean, there's always room for improvement.
No. But, I mean, you thought 9.5.
9.5.
9.58. All right.
Okay.
Tommy, you may as well go ahead.
Tom?
I'm terrible with R&B music.
I knew you were going to say that. I almost said that myself. Because it's not your thing.
It's just not.
I'm drinking on the mic.
When records come out and they say house, but it's really R&B, it's just messing me up because then I'm thinking totally different. And so therefore, because I'm an old school house head, I just don't get it. So I'm a poor judge on it. I'm going to give it a 5 because of the ladies will love it. And hey, you got to please the ladies.
All right. I like it. It's a 9 to me. It's a 9 just because of like mixed quality stuff. I thought that the vocal needed a little bit more treatment in places. But other than that, it's really good. The song is good. The music was good. The track is good. Drums are good. It's good. And looks like we got 100% over.
We got 100%
on Twitch.
Hey, and Jawan Helm over on, let me see what Ed Ramsey says. Okay, Ed Ramsey, lovely track, great vocals, the arrangement builds nicely, love the use of the sax. Definitely a 9+. This person, I don't want to say always, but generally uses real musicians. Robert Danos Ketcher says, production is smooth, but the vocals are lazy. Okay, lazy and too repetitive. Lavelle, who is this? Lavelle Love?
Lavelle, yeah.
Are you from Baltimore? I like you. Joint, nice. 9.5. That's if you're not from Baltimore, you don't understand, but you might. If you're from other joint places nice. In America, you might understand. Anyway, joint, nice. 9.5. Yes. Okay, Nicola. Nicola only giving this one a 6.5. Barbara Tucker, straight up Jersey and some house parties in ATL.
It is.
Okay.
It is. No doubt.
It is.
Okay.
It's the new sound. It's
new sound?
Yeah.
Okay. Sound. All right. Well, we got much love for this one. And we are going to, 8.5 over on Mixcloud from DJ Sir Roddick.
What's 8.5. Up, man?
8.5. Love the musicality. All right, so we got some DJs ready to play this one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. All right. It is coming to a Quantize release near you.
It is. No question about that. So let's see. Oh, I think John's trying to chime back in.
DJ Eureka 72, 9.0, Jersey in the house.
What's up?
DJ B510 says, it's got me wanting to shine my shoes right now. It was this very smooth track. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it's definitely signable material, so great work.
All right.
Great work.
Timothy Callahan is going to give this one some love, too. We'll definitely play this. What's up, Timothy Callahan?
Yep.
All right.
All right. So, we're going to go on to our next track.
Laval Misto says, Chicago produced money, y'all. Sign my track. Okay. Okay. Baltimore, Chicago, whatever.
Yeah.
Both ghetto. I mean, and I'm from Baltimore, so I say that with love. I said that with a lot of love.
Oh, my Lord.
I said that with a lot of love.
Okay, so we're going on to track number 4.
Okay, this track right here has a sample. I want you to drop in the chat if you can catch the sample on this one. The sample is sped up a little bit for about 8 seconds and then 3 seconds somewhere else. It's Talent Tuesday. Stay with us.
What? Thank you.
no. When the producer said, you know, told me what the sample was. But honestly, the sample is one of my favorite songs. And I said, how many seconds? Because I didn't have time to listen to it. And so the producer told me how many seconds. And I was like, you know what? Let's just let it go. And I'm actually glad I did. So I'm interested in hearing what Tommy and Spen have to say about this one and all of you out there. DJ Mai Tai, of course, Baltimore showing off. Yep. DJ Mai Tai out of Baltimore.
She was the first one that said, she said she Jones Girls. I was like, that don't sound like Jones Girls to me.
She clocked the Jones Girls very early on. Yes, Mai it is. She has an extensive musical knowledge.
I know why your
knowledge.
Name is Mai Tai.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. Yes, so indeed. What do you all think? Tommy?
It's a unique style, and let me speak from the business side of it. For us, we haven't got this audience yet. We've tried to get this audience that like this, because I love it. Personally, I love Jackin' House. I just love it. But it's really hard for our audience to be listening to Quantize and then listen to Unquantize with this Afro, hardcore, underground sound, and then go Jackin'. We still keep trying, but I like this. I mean, the way the bass line is under it, and you know, you have to get used to Jackin' only using a sample. And that takes skill to take a song and take a sample and just filter it in and make it be, you know, you hear the Jones Girls just work by itself. So I give this definitely an 8. It's like, you know, this is a really great work. Your transitions, how you got from one to another, a little, you could work on it, but still, this is Jackin' House all day.
Okay, so that's an 8 from you. And Kelly, I guess you give it high scores.
I like it. I mean, and it's not actually something I would normally be like, yes, right away, but I want to see what Twitch says. We're running a poll on Twitch right now. So take that, because I see, I think Biscuit and some others are in the chat on Twitch.
I want to know what Biscuit thinks.
Yeah, I want to hear from the DJs. Would you play it? I want to hear from the producers. Talk to us. And I'm checking you out on Facebook. Ooh. I'll come back to your comments in a minute.
Hey, Kelly. So, it's Ben. Here's an interesting thing that we need to really cover somehow. Because Lamour brought a good point. He says, hey, depends on your morals on copyright infringement.
So we talk about this a lot. And we normally... I mean, in general, and I'm going to speak very generally, because obviously, I mean, you can listen to our catalog and you know we have exceptions. Some of those exceptions have been cleared and some have just been such a minimal use that we've not cleared it. But I will say this, when we use a sample, if we do not have the owner's permission, and we haven't done some sort of license or agreement for it, we don't take everything. We still give them the credit. Yeah. So that means we don't get paid. We're not getting paid for all of the song. We set it aside and we just list the original, you know, whether it's a songwriter or whatever it is, we list them as on the credit. So you can go to many of our songs and you'll see that. I mean, and that's not just us, that's how it's done, right? You know, you can ask DJ Spen, who learned that lesson at a very young age. You know, yes, someone can take your song and your name is on there as, you know, the producer, your name is on there as a songwriter, and so that's what we do. So in general, we tell people, no, we don't. When we're looking for demos, we're looking for original work. And in this case, I did let it go. I didn't listen to how much, but the producer said, hey, it's 3 seconds here, and then it's 11 seconds of it there. And then he got into some technical stuff, like I time stretched it and did all this. I'm like, okay, well, let's hear it. And I really wanted to hear it because I knew it was Jones Girls, and I really like Jones Girls. So that's what we do.
Scale of 1 to 10, I give it a 7. I give it a 7.
You get a 7.
Yeah.
All right.
And because it's creative use of the sample, I think the sound quality is not quite right.
Yeah.
And I think the arrangement's not quite right.
Right.
But man, it definitely does have potential.
It's got potential. We've got 50-50. Yeah, I don't know if I think it's a clever use of the sample. I don't feel for it the way I do the other track, but I feel like it has a lot of potential there.
Yeah.
50-50 over on Twitch. Angelica Deneau says it's got a lot of potential. DJ Scoop, on the other hand, says nope.
Says no, no, no.
Who's that? DJ B510 likes the loop. You know, that loop is bumping.
What's up, DJ B?
DJ Eureka 72 thinks it's a good transitional track. So we've got a mixed, you know, mixed. Chuck Dancer says it gives me early Todd Terry vibes. So, you know, lots of different feedback here on this one. Let's go over and see if Facebook is saying anything. Hey, Tonio, okay, no, so that's a no. Okay, Barbara says 2-in-1 song. You don't really feel it till the loop comes in. So, okay.
Right, yeah, right. I mean, yeah, it's right. It is. It's two different things going on. But I actually like this part right here. I mean, if I had never known, if the other part that's didn't come in, I would have been like, okay, but that's where Mai Tai. I hear what you hear, Mai Tai. That's good work. Good work.
Yeah, so, who's that? Go ahead, Tommy.
So in general, what we try to do is play fair. So we write songs. So we listen to it and say, does it actually steal what the person wrote the song for?
Right.
And so if it does, we automatically give them the credit. Like, you know what? Right. You get the credit because that's straight out of the song. The way
and anybody it. Can hear it. You know, Helen Keller could have heard it. So you definitely, you know, if you're just re-singing or it's, you know, you're just reinterpreting and it's really, you can hear the, if you can catch it right away and say, oh, that's that song, we've got to give, you have to.
Correct.
You have to.
I wouldn't want nobody to do that to me.
And that's right.
And really, that's the criteria, right?
Right, right.
That right there is the criteria. There you know what I mean? Somebody's clever enough to use your sample and you don't know what it is, then that's on whatever. Right. But if you're using a sample and you know and it's clear what it is, that's a whole nother thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mix 93 FM says, with a radio mix, we will add this to their rotation easily.
You know what? And big up. So check it out. Uh-huh. Mix 93 plays so much of our music that it's ridiculous. So thank you so much for a major radio station and they're in LA. So, you know, to be playing and embracing what it is that we do. Kudos. Mad love to you. Let us know if you need anything. But yeah, we love you for that. And thank you so much.
Yeah, a lot of people felt like it started off a bit slow, which at first I was like, what is
it? It did. It started out, that's what I'm saying. The arrangement was very weird, but clever. It's still very cleverly done. It's like at no point was it, it started out slow and then it went to this section that we love so much. And then all of a sudden it bounced over into, you know, which is a very interesting way to use the sample, I thought. I was like, I don't really like it that much, but when the kick came in, it's like. That's just rocking.
DJ Sir Roddick over on Mixcloud giving it a 7 and needs some polishing.
Yeah,
we've got some, we've got some no's. All right. Barbara says they both work, but one's different. It comes in moving more so. All right. We have one more track, and we save this one for last because this is a fixer. So some of the producers make the decision. Oh,
so this is a return from last week?
I think it's actually from last week.
It is from last week.
Yeah, it is. So some of the producers say, I'm taking my stuff elsewhere. Some have to go deal with their feelings for a little while before they come back. This person jumped right back into the studio. I think there was some new vocals or some re-sung vocals on this one, I believe. So let's check it out. Some of you, if you were here 2 weeks ago, you might remember this one. Let's see how it is. It says, wait a minute. It says, I re-sang the vocals.
Re-sang
with more feelings and more... and made and try to make it more believable, as your wonderful panel advised me to. It is not mastered yet, but that's all right. We're not expecting fully mastered tracks, but let's check it out.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
All right, this is Don't Break It.
Don't Break It.
Re-return on Talent Tuesday as the music continues.
work into it. I can hear the difference. You hear the difference?
I don't necessarily remember the track, but I like this.
Okay. Well, that's telling you something right there.
Yeah. That's
okay. Well, 80% yes on Twitch. Another 20% said it still needs a little bit more work. But they didn't get any no's on that one. So not too bad from Twitch. We got an 8 from Ed Ramsey. We have a 7 from Nicola Cavarelli. Ronan Ramos gave it a 5. All right. So we have some positive feedback going on.
Uh-huh.
All right. Tommy Davis.
What you think?
Oh, much improvement. A lot.
You remember it from last time?
Yes.
Okay.
But not too much. It wasn't that memorable. But this is memorable. So so it's a classic. It's just the way it was sang this time. It's a classic, like Claude Jabari, some classic disco singers.
Yeah.
Now you got to make the track and come up to her because she is nailing it lyrically. She is nailing it. This is a hit record. It's a hit record. But now because you have some chord clashes in there somewhere, and she is riding on a whole nother thing to herself. You know what I mean? So it's probably some little tweaks here and there to make her and the music go together, because she's done doing these moves and bridges and stuff, but the music isn't. And it's such a great song. It's just nailed it. You know what I mean? You just nailed that song. So I actually keep working on it, because that, I can see people singing it. I can see it do well in areas that we can't even reach. Mm-hmm. So good work. I give it an 8. Just the fact that you got the courage to come back. That's what we're talking about.
And you came back better.
Right. Came back swinging.
Yeah.
Let's see. Ed Ramsey and a couple others said the vocals are given kind of Lisa Stansfield. Ed Ramsey says Brand New Heavies kind of vibe there.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah. What did you think, Spen?
Scale of 1 to 10, I give it an 8. I like the vocalist. I even like the musicianship.
Spen, you made me do this. When I'm missing the keys and the bass and the music, and then when you got those keys like that, if they crash with a moving bass line, it kind of makes the vocalist feel like they didn't sing to it. You know what I mean? See, she's going right there.
To this, though. Yeah, I like it, man.
I like it too.
I really do like it. If there's anything that I would do is, you know, to further what's going on here, I mean, some horns or something to sort of sing around, you know what I'm saying, with what's going on. Mm-hmm. You know, some strength, you know. And I think I hear a string one.
It's a pad.
Yeah. But she sounds, what I like about this more than anything, she sounds awesome. She sounds confident. Really, really good.
Yeah. It's a hit record.
Jeez. Now it's good. You know, Roy Ayers sounding, Roy Ayers guy sound, you know, with the Rhodes.
Yeah.
Shit, the vocals are much stronger than they were before.
Yeah. I don't even remember the other one, to be fair.
They were structured, very, you know, like, no, emotionless.
That's good. It's very well done. I love the bass line, live bass, live guitars.
Yeah.
You know, if you want to take it one step further, you know, you add some horns on this.
Hey, can I say one thing?
Sure.
Hey, master this, and I would love to hear it mastered. You know what I mean? Because, like you said, it's not mastered or nothing like that, so we're not really getting the depth of your work. You know what I mean? If you mastered it, I would love to hear the master.
What score did you give it, Spen?
Huh?
What score did you give it? You gave it an 8?
Yeah. I mean, I like the arrangement.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she may need. She is pitchy. But what I like about it is that as it goes, it gets better. You know, this is like back to the beginning of the song. So you could tell the vocalist was feeling it.
Yeah.
She's feeling it, man. Yeah.
I like it. And I do it all the time. When I do productions, and sometimes you're working with the song so much that you, when you finally get something to go right, you stop paying attention to the other stuff. And you know, that's what sound like it is. It's like you was really thrilled with the vocal and you were thrilled with the music. So now, you were in production, you can make it work. All you gotta do is go and tweak it so it fits together.
Yeah. John, did you hear that last record? Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, we lost you. Well, we can see you, but we can't hear you. Yeah.
Oh, the electrician put the power off.
The electrician.
John had an electrical issue.
He had an electrical issue, so
at his house.
Yeah. Are you on Chrome still? Or did you? Yeah. I don't know why we can't hear you. Oh, maybe you have to select your you have to go into settings and maybe select your sound.
Yeah, I really would be interested in hearing what John.
I would love to hear what he has to say about that.
Oh, that's strong record.
Yeah, he has the link, so I may get John to, if we can't get him on, I may get him to send me some feedback so I can chat with the...
John did records like this all his career.
Yeah, that's why I said I really would love to hear what he has to say
If he touches something like this, it's just going to be a record.
All right. No doubt. We'll see if he can get it.
Are
you looking for something to write with?
No, I'm looking from the phone.
Oh, now we can hear you.
It said the host has muted your mic, so I was like, no. Okay.
No, I wasn't. You weren't muted on my side, but yeah, but now we can.
Well, maybe the mic or Tommy muted me.
Never.
Well, the electrician came. He promised me that my power wouldn't go off again, but now I don't know where I left my phone, so I'm going to be hunting it soon. So anyway, I only caught like the very end of the track.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But I definitely think it's something we can work with. I think it's almost probably the best track of the night for me.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. It is.
I knew that was up his alley.
Yeah, totally agree. Definitely. Yeah, between that and the boogie butt, yeah, we're good.
Boogie butt, boogie pants.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I would definitely seriously consider those two for quantize, and just check with the producers to see exactly, you know, what kind of session it is, you know, whether it's like a bunch of loops or something, or whether it's an actual real production that we can work with.
This is that's killer.
He didn't hear the Lamour Disco one.
Yeah. Ooh, and he didn't hear it then, and we have a Lamour Disco record that we'll send to you.
Yeah, no, but I think Kelly sent me a link to them, so I have.
Yeah, you have all have of them anyway. Yeah.
So I have so all of them.
Go and listen to track number 3.
And, right. I'm gonna download them because, you know, it's funny. We were just talking early today. I was saying, you know, we need some stuff for, you know, for me to do because I'm kind of getting tired and this stuff. You know, it's hard trying to be a producer and try to continuously try to make tracks and come up with different things to do, because sometimes your brain just gets fried, you know, and it's good to hear something else from somebody else that you can contribute to, you know. Uh-huh. It doesn't, you know, the whole weight doesn't always have to be on you, you know, which has always been the good thing about our relationship. Is that I can get a track and I can start up and then I can send it, you know, to Spen and Tommy, and they can, like, you know, finish it and take it to the next level, and then I'll mix it, because it's always good, you know, to collaborate on things, because usually collaborations give the best results, you know?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Say that again. Right.
I mean, you guys can agree, it's not easy trying to do everything by yourself, you know?
Yeah.
You know, you gotta make the record, you gotta play the instruments, make the record, promote the record. It's just like, it's hard being a one-man band, you know? I mean, you know, none of us have fucking 20 people teams, you know?
No.
Correct.
You know, we trying to make the best records we can with the least amount of financial damage, you know, because people don't realize, you know, that a lot of these musicians and people, you know, want to get paid. So it's very difficult a lot of times when you're constantly getting asked for people, can you send me this? Can you send me that? Can you send me this? And then they get pissed off when you send them a link to go buy it, you know, and say, listen, you know, I have to pay the singer, I have to pay the guitar player, I have to pay the keyboard player, you got the string guy, you got the horns guy, and we're lucky if we can make our money back.
Yeah. It's a blessing. You know, that's what they ain't going sure.
Well, a lot of people don't realize that. You know, they think we're getting fat and rich because we got a number one on TaxSource, you know, and you know, you get your statement from TaxSource, you made like $5, you know?
You're right.
Right, but I do want to, you know, send out my love to everybody that's been in the chat, and you know, appreciate, you know, that they do support, you know, Quantize and the music that, you know, we try to make, you know, from our hearts and our souls. So, you know, hopefully they can appreciate it, you know, go download it, and you know, wait for the next one.
Yep,
that's right.
Because it is on. It is.
Because the next one could be the one you heard tonight.
Yep.
Yeah. It has happened.
It has happened.
It has happened. Just ask Conti. I think Conti.
Just ask Conti. That's right. I did see Conti in that. Right.
And Lamar Disco.
And who did I see? Was it Anane? Who was playing Conti's song recently? I saw someone playing Conti, and they were also playing, interestingly enough, were playing Bringing the Cats. And I was like, okay. Yeah.
Might have been Anane.
Yeah.
See, well, that's the whole premise of Talent Tuesday, is to give some of these, not even lesser known producers, but some of these other producers an opportunity.
Yes.
You know, to get their stuff out, because everybody always complains, you know, it's not always about getting your record out on Defected or some, you know, Tool Room or one of these other labels, you know. So Quantize offers an opportunity to a lot of these guys, not only to hear their stuff, but to get advice on things that might not even totally be finished, or how to take their music to the next level, you know. And in some cases, like some of the stuff we heard tonight, a possibility of getting released on Quantize and having Spen and Tommy and myself or other people mix it and give it, you know, give it that life that they originally started out with.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Which is kind of like the idea, you know, I mean, really getting producers to a point where somebody like a Defected or Tool Room will look at, you know, what they're doing. And that's what this is really all about. But man, what a show. Even though you weren't around for a couple of records, still, man, I mean, it's like, it was a really, really good show. And
I'll be back.
John, we
appreciate
you, man.
I'll be back. I'm home more often, so I can definitely jump on more often.
All right. Well, it's on. We're going to hold you to it for sure. All right. Man.
Hey, John.
But thank you so much.
Yes.
Man, we really appreciate you. What a lot of people don't know is that when you hear these records and we have to replay the whole thing, so you hear a classic, and John is just a really advocate of the original sound. So we spend a lot of time trying to recreate a sound just so you can say, hey, I remember that record. Or for the new people to say, to appreciate what the original was. And a lot of them couldn't do it without you, John, man. Thank you so much.
Well, I appreciate it. I mean, my whole kind of mission is to try to educate and bring the music that I love to today's current DJs and music fan. You know, because, you know, we don't try to reinvent the wheel. We just try to, you know, present it in a new light, you know, like,
right.
I mean, everything that we've done, all the Spencer Morale stuff, you know, the Caught Up, the Curtis Hairston, you know, the Jones Girls cover, you know, I mean, they're all true to the original, but in a modern way. Right. You know, and the point that Tommy was making earlier today, which is something that I had discussed with Spen, is that the tempos nowadays just seem to be getting higher and higher. You know, it's like before,
getting faster.
Right, we were rocking 118, 120, maybe 122. I mean, I'm jumping on as like the second DJ in some of these places, and the guy's like already like 128, 130, and I'm like, oh, I don't have anything.
What are we going to do with that? Right.
Right. So, you know, so that's a big discussion that we have when we're making these records. It's like, okay, what's the tempo? And I always lived in that kind of, that swing, that 118, 120 bounce, and I'm finding myself forcing to go in up to like 122 because a lot of guys, you know, they look at the tempo and they say 120 is too slow. So they don't even give it an opportunity.
Right.
You know? Right. So I mean, as a producer as we are, you also have to look at what some of the trends are. And not that we have to follow the trend, but sometimes, you know, you have to incorporate some of these new elements into what you're trying to do to make sure that you can reach all these audiences, you know, and give your stuff an opportunity to be heard, you know. Yeah. So, all I mean, things have changed, you know.
Every bit matters. Everything.
I mean, you know, we're talking about, you know, like Act Like You Know, Fat Larry's band, which is 106 beats per minute. You know, we're trying to figure out, okay, where are we going to go with this?
Right. Right, you know, but where that's going to be interesting. When we do that record, I'm telling you, we're going to turn some.
I mean, I did my little part. I've given it to Spen. Now he's got some ideas, and then we're going to bounce it around. You know, so a lot of this stuff takes a lot of effort and a lot of discussion between myself and Spen and Tommy and stuff.
Yeah.
And Kelly with her 2 cents on the side, whether she likes something or not. Yeah. You know, so all that is important, you know, especially, you know, people on the outside of our lives. You know, like Spen has Kelly, who has a knowledge of the music, and she also knows what she likes and doesn't like. You know, and even though sometimes we may kid around, you know, these opinions are important to us because it makes us think about some things that maybe we wouldn't have thought about.
Yeah.
You know, so anyway, again, you know, I can ramble on, you know, but I just want everybody to know that we put our heart and soul into everything we do, and we're proud of the music we make, and we hope that you love it as much as we do making it.
Ladies and gentlemen, he just dropped the mic. It's John Morales. And one of our favorite producers and co-producers here. It's amazing. But thank you so much, man, for joining us tonight. And we are definitely going to have you back here on Talent Tuesday. Listen, if you have something that you would like for us to review, demos at quantizerecordings.com is where you can send it. Send it to us. And we'll give you a good critique, and maybe it's something that you'll hear as a future record on Quantize Recording.
Wait, Spen. Demos is if you want to submit to the label. Music at Quantize.
Oh, music at Quantize. Sorry. Yeah, no. See how I had to be corrected? See?
Talent Tuesdays,
you want it to go to music, right?
Right.
Demos is a whole nother thing. So yes, right. he is correct. From the three of us, because we've had people that had to go off, but from the three of us, peace in the valley, peace in the city, and peace to your souls. We love all of you. Thank you for hanging out with us for this special edition, birthday boy edition of Talent Tuesday. Happy birthday, once again, John.
And I will leave with God bless everybody. And may everybody live in peace and happiness.
All right. It's on. All right. All right. And Tommy Davis, thank you as well. All right, John. Have a good one here.
All right. Love to you. Take care.
All right. Okay, so that does it for this Talent Tuesday. I'm hoping that for the next Talent Tuesday, we will have another killer legend, but this time from across the water. I'm going to try to get Danny Rambling on the show. If we get Danny Rambling on the show, that'll be in another couple of weeks. But stay tuned. I mean, we've got some heavy-duty guests coming on throughout the summer. before we break in August. August is going to be just when we're going to take a big break with it and then hit you back over the head again next September. But thank you all again for joining us. Peace in the valley, peace in the city, peace to your souls. I just said that, and I am out. Goodbye, y'all. See y'all later.